I was at Cliff Top Fiddlers Convention years ago, and there was a group of young people right across at their campsite, and they were playing that tune, and they were playing the wrong chords. And I walk over there, and I'm standing, and I'm listening to them, and I'm getting ready to correct them, and the guitar player looks at me and goes, "It's your tune, isn't it?" I said, "Yeah." He said, "We don't like your chords." I went, "Okay." So, you know, it's the folk process. Once you put it out there, it's going wherever it's going to go.
Yeah, it's going to be killer.
It's a similar thing with the Reeves. I see that the Reeves has been repurposed. For me, the new life is more exciting than the old one, actually. What is my
You can't replace live music. For me personally, you'll never take away that personal connection of it.
Well, I grew up in a small town.
Because that's how you really build a fan base.
It's where I learned to be my own man.
A lot of our friends are people that we solely met because we played a show somewhere.
I was shaking my head, rolling my eyes at the things you said. Put your hand on my back and your finger on my lip. Before I know it, I'm shaking my hip, baby, shake.
I really believe in the sacredness of all music. And I mean all music. By that, it might not be sacred to you, but it's sacred to somebody.
Now I can't.
The more we can create spaces where people can not only consume music, but make music, then that's just better for our communities. This area is so full of music lovers. It's a great place to be an artist.
Part of what has fed my class of people who are interested in violin making is the richness of the music in this area. Just about everybody in the world who's trying to play old-time music is trying to play Surrey County music. Almost all of my friends are old-time musicians.
It's an old tradition, something that's unique to this area. You just share what you know. And I think it's neat that it gets passed on by ear because inevitably it's gonna change a little bit.
We'll get better, I swear we will. I'm gonna go home and practice.
I bet you will too.
It's a real tight-knit area. We do have the talent to do it, and we have the people that love it and the people that love to play. There's so much love for music, but we don't have an outlet for that, really. All we're missing is nothing to do with the musicians.
There's no regular venue where you can go and hear great music through a great sound system on a regular basis. The downtown really needs help. I don't know, I just see the Reeves as being something really important to the area, really, really important to Elkin. And I sort of see it as opening up the downtown.
I have been a baker, a proofreader, a full-time mom, a high school English teacher, served on various boards and been involved in this community for many years now. 37, as a matter of fact.
You're in oak and I'm pine.
So this turned out to be the place where both of our children grew up and where our family has lived.
Elkin is really unique in that it's only one school system, so all the kids get to know each other and all the parents get to know each other. And we joke, you don't have any secrets because your local friends also see you in the liquor store. But
right. Elkin is a little town that has all the sort of qualities that you think of when you think of small town America. It has a cute little downtown area. It has farmland nearby. It has rolling hills and good public schools. It checks all the boxes for a quaint small town.
This is, you know, tobacco country and was furniture and textile mill country. And economically, the landscape has changed radically over the last couple decades.
Elkin went through a simultaneous issue of Chatham Manufacturing closing and the big box stores moving in. A lot of shops downtown that sold just basic goods closed. So I think a lot of us as kids were anxious to get out of Elkin and do other things. I know when I was growing up, I took piano lessons and I sang in the church choir, but there was a whole folk music scene that was just happening and there wasn't much crossover.
Did you get that whiskey that I left in your backyard? I would kill him to see you, babe, but another man got me, boy.
Oldest cousin that lived in Apex near Raleigh, and he would play the coolest stuff in his car. I'm like, what is this? At that age, it wasn't like I was, Mom, will you take me to like the record store? Like, we didn't have one anyway.
Now I see that there are 4-year-olds, 5-year-olds who are picking up folk instruments and are really good at them.
I feel like there is sort of a boom going on. There are lots of festivals and musicians who are building on those traditions, who have the roots, now are branching out.
There's an audience now that's available. A couple of the bars or wineries have had live music, and we've run into bands we didn't know existed playing all kinds of music. There were a lot of things like house parties. You know, you might have 3 different groups playing in 3 different rooms in one house. It's just been terrific for a couple of music lovers like us.
Because of all the music in the region and because of all these opportunities, more people coming into town, something needed to be happening at night.
And to be able to do something with that, even if we just are the hosts rather than the performers, is very exciting to us.
We had been sort of looking at spaces. We looked at 3 other buildings before the Reeves became available, before we heard that it might be up for sale. Been sitting there like dead space, a drag on Elkin, just this heavy load, you know, for everybody who walked by and saw it just empty and dead.
The first time I saw the Reeves was in 1995. It looked like a derelict building with the facade falling off. At the time, I was photographing abandoned structures in North Carolina, and as I was going through Elkin, I noticed the Reeves Theater, which didn't know the name of it, of course, but photographed it back in, I think, 97. Never did I dream I would be in here working on it at that point. Yes, the Reeves was originally a movie theater that opened in 1941.
So Dr. Reeves was an eye doctor and thought, you know, I'm going to build a theater because we need a theater. That's what Elkin needed.
Movie theaters were also where you got the local news, the national news. You know, the newsreels would come in and play before the films.
It has really been a fixture for a long time. And I think everybody has fond memories. We took our kids to movies there.
Because I know I went there and I saw The Lion King there.
It was great. You would call up. And he would give you this really, he'd go, tonight we've got, you know, and he would give you a whole synopsis of what the storyline was of some movie and go through all the movies he had going on and stuff.
Many folks have walked in and said, right over here is where I had my first kiss and I met my wife right here. And it's cool to hear those stories and they remember the life that it had.
There's just a whole lot of nostalgia and attachment to the place.
Late 80s, early 90s, multiplex cinemas are popping up all over, and small downtown cinemas struggled to pay the bills. The roof had started leaking, and there was some major damage, and it had to close.
Anything that could be damaged was damaged.
There was, at one time, several hundred cats that lived in here.
The first time I went in, I didn't really believe that it could be renovated. You know, it felt unhealthy to even be inside.
So I think the demolition part of it probably scared most people away.
It took a few years for another group to purchase the building, repair the roof, and stabilize the condition of the building. One of the most ardent supporters of the Reeves was Cicely McCulloch.
It was on the chopping block to be torn down, to then create parking is what would happen. But it was kind of like, you have more parking for what? And that's just not me. I can't tear it. I wouldn't tear any old structure down if I could help it.
And the goal was this pretty amazing arts center.
We'd had a lot of people come to us and say, oh, we want to help you raise some money. Nobody followed through like Sam Taylor did.
Sam Taylor has been one of the biggest cheerleaders for the Reeves.
I think as people, we want to better what we do. And so a town or city should be no different.
Got there and back blues, there and back blues.
Here's this young kid who says, I want to help raise some money and have a music event.
First year of Reefstock was about 500 folks. It's been able to really grow very steadily, and we don't see any reason why we're not going to get close to 5,000 folks this year. I mean, I take the festival really seriously, that you might not know all the bands that come, but I know you're going to like it. We're going to bring quality music to Elkin.
We figured he'd do it once, and we figured he'd do it twice. He kept going, knowing that the love of music was going to continue to grow.
With a place like the Reeves, with a town like Elkin, you're just always going to be battling the fact that we are tiny. We're a tiny town. And so I think that their vision, while amazing, was probably not sustainable long term.
I think the love for it was there. People were giving money, but it was a dime in a bucket compared to what they need.
We had done what we could with the Reeves, knew that we were at the end of our donations, and thought, now what do we do? What's going to happen now?
And that's when we sort of panicked and said, no, we have to do something. I don't think we would have done it if it hadn't been for Eric. You know, we needed somebody with the practical skills to turn the building into what we wanted. It really is what made it possible.
That's really true. His background in construction, but also his artistic sensibility and work as a, you know, creative kind of person.
Debbie and I became friends and did a lot of work together as volunteers through the Arts Council. And one day she sat me down and said that her and Chris were thinking about opening a music venue. And they were looking at a building in downtown Elkin and really would like me to join them in this progress. And at that time, I also heard that the nonprofit that owned the Reeves Theater was thinking about selling it.
We took a deep breath and thought, I don't know if we can jump off that cliff.
And we said, really? Let's give you this and we'll sell it to you for what is our balance on a loan that we had. I said, here, we want you to have it because we know you're going to take it and do great things with it. The same way I took private money and did what I was able to do here.
She purchased the old Liberty building, which was a tobacco warehouse and then a wholesale grocery warehouse, and now is Angry Troll Brewery and a very nice event space.
And that was also a building that existed vacant for a long time. Many people had ideas of what could be done with it. Just takes someone to push the first domino.
We've been inspired by the energy that's come, the economic forces. I think the Yadkin Valley wine region, such an essential piece of building tourism. And then people who have built trails, that's becoming such a huge piece of what's happening around here.
It's like everything is saying, okay, now it is time to really make Elkin a destination.
So, just more and more, it seemed that the time was right to go ahead and take a leap.
The stars align.
I've known Chris and Debbie probably since I was 11 years old. They asked if I would help them out. The Reeves was, at that point in time, pretty much a bare shell. Debbie and Chris both said, hey, this is a canvas. Make of it what you will.
We had one empty box, and we could be free to do what we found visually appealing.
We wanted something different than what you see on a daily basis in construction.
We decided to let music inspire us in the interior and build a stage which has a side that resembles the side of a guitar. It can suggest several instruments, really. But we have the original tile on the floor in the lobby. I think the primary thing that we will be able to restore is the Art Deco facade.
To me, the fact that it's original and it's something you just don't see anymore, this is very important. As you're doing the construction, you're really thinking about, well, how is this going to function for me 10 years from now? We've tried to do everything in a way that it will last as long as possible and hold up for the long term.
Every little piece that is on the Reeves, Debbie and Chris did everything they can to source that stuff locally and find people around the community that had the skills to bring this back to life.
We are not corporate, we're a small LLC with an in-house staff of construction workers that are all local fellas or transplants. Most of them are musicians. Several of the musicians have actually approached us to work on the project just to say they've had a part in it.
Right, yeah, I've had my hands all over that place for the last year and a half. It's just interesting to see it progress. There's so many curves. There's like not a flat wall in the place, really, except for the original brick. It doesn't have to be square. It's not supposed to be square.
They're not cutting corners, but they're doing such a great job at maintaining the originality of that building and the funk of it, and at the same time adding pretty modern stuff.
There are similarities to the work. You always encounter problems, issues that you have to find solutions to and fix. And that's the same thing with violin making. You're constructing something, you know, whether it's a stuccoed wall or a tiled wall, or carving a piece of wood.
I see a sense of pride in being part of the project. I don't know if we ever found a crew that could have done what we've done. Not that there aren't talented people, but just translating our vision into actual reality, I think we were the only ones that could do that.
You've got a fan of the project for life because you've invited someone to share their skill set, to share their talents and abilities with that project. All of those people are now part of that project forever.
We're very dedicated to having a good sounding hall, and we've had somebody involved right from the start.
I bring in the experience of having toured with the band professionally for 16 years. You come in and you bring your equipment in with the band you're working with, and you have a lot to complain about. The acoustics or the sound system or the power or the stage or the curtains. It's just fun to be in the process included early on.
Great sound is the most important thing. If I can hear well on stage and hear the people around me without it being too loud, that's when I play the best.
I was in that band, Dolly Buffalo, for 9 years, and I can probably count on one hand the venues that I thought were incredible, and the sound man was great, and the sound system was great. And then the rest of them were just these guys that were frustrated musicians that were pissed off to have to twist the knobs or whatever, you know?
A lot of venues are just a room that they decided to throw a stage in and a sound system, but this is in a whole nother league from those.
The actual ceiling above the stage, the angle of it, the corrugatedness of it, the texture of it is all designed for sound. Every little detail has been thought about for sound.
I think what's special and unique about the Reeves, no matter where you would sit in the audience, you would get a similar experience.
No one is very far away from the artist on the stage.
I hope that the musicians will confirm what we've tried to design, but when they play, they can hear themselves well, they can perform their best performance. They hear the power they have in the room.
Once touring musicians realize what that space is, they're gonna wanna come there. We should practice here every week.
We could sneak in at night. And
you could leave a door open while you're working.
Because we wanted to have a bar, we learned that North Carolina requires any establishment that's not a winery to have a menu. So we thought maybe foot traffic through a cafe would help generate a little buzz. We've hired a young woman who grew up in Elkin to be the chef. She went to the Wilkes Culinary Institute.
I worked in a group home for about 7 years, and I enjoyed cooking for large amounts of people. It's therapeutic, I would say, especially making bread. I love to bake bread. There's just something so fulfilling about making a loaf of bread and watching it rise. We're gonna do farm to table. And so we get to utilize a lot of these local farmers that are in the area. Kind of brings everything back home.
Mm-hmm.
halfway through the project, there was a point where it seemed like we'd been working and working and working, and we still had a long ways to go. And it felt like, I don't know if we'll ever make it. My energy level was dwindling. There's 5 days of grinding bolts off the wall, and there's 2 days of fixing holes in the floor. You know, just the little things start adding up.
They say this is fiddling on the Reeves Theater?
Yep.
Okay.
You just did.
This is fiddling on top of the Reeves Theater.
Freaking out, they're not second guessing themselves, they're just accepting that, you know, we are making something bigger than ourselves, and that's gonna take time and it's gonna take energy, and it's okay, it'll happen when it happens.
Now we're kind of real close to being on the finish line, and it's feeling a little more comfortable and accessible to finish it.
It is most definitely a work of art. It's so beautiful. It feels like sculpture. It feels like you're standing in the middle of a sculpture.
And to see the Reeves back exactly the way it was on the facade, pretty cool.
Once we're up and running, I think there'll be this new revelation of, even though it's not the same as it was, but it has life again.
The Reeves, to me, is progress. And damn it, it's gonna be open now.
Rising, steaming moves. Now I'm gonna run this lightning. Now I'm gonna bring it to you. I'm on this highway, about to put the hammer down.
Yeah, we've been chasing stuff all day, all week, trying to get all the little things worked out.
So. Now, and I'm Appalachian.
How is it possible to be this excited and this terrified at the same time?
Terrified, but excited, yes.
Yes, actually.
Yeehaw!
Here comes that old night. The moon, it's on my back now. The moon's my only light. Tommy's riding shotgun in my 42.
A year ago, we started a committee to get Elkin downtown going again, and everything is really changing downtown. This is a game changer for Elkin.
Okay. All right, everybody ready? Got the Kodak ready? One, two, three.
Thank you, everybody, for turning out.
Go in where it's warm.
Elkin has been a wonderful place to live. I can't believe that we're talking about decades now. We've lived here almost four decades, which is staggering to me. I know supposedly it takes a village. I think in our case it's taken a whole town. We look forward to the future.
About 4 years ago, we bought the theater. While we were deliberating, this little voice in the back of all of our heads was saying, go ahead and do it. You can make it work. Go ahead. I later figured out that that was Sam Taylor's voice. So, Sam, in many ways, thank you. The stage is yours.
I guess the Reeves is new. It's always been a dilapidated building, closed up, boarded up. So I think that it's an unveiling for me. It's a new music venue, which there's not too much more that gets me excited.
This life's got me tied to a bowling chain. Oh, I'm getting ready. Oh, I'm gonna break away.
All right, thank you so much, everybody.
Russell McCumber, folks.
I don't think it's going to bother people that it's not a movie theater anymore. It's been a fixture for so long in this town. It's coming back to life, and that's what excites people.
One, to feel good. Two, to feel fine. Won't be feeling nothing when you run it three times. Spend all my money on fine red wine. Never spend a dime on.
It is such a huge labor of love to restore an historic theater. It's taken a big chunk of their lives to do this. It's just going to be a center point for musicians in Elkin and beyond.
It takes a lot to keep a Main Street going. So whether this is, you know, the tipping point that really turns Elkin, I hope so. It could have a massive economic impact on what can happen for the other storefronts.
We just need more building owners to make a difference. But because of the Reeves, and hopefully because of the Liberty, people are gonna take that risk.
Some people just see a pile of junk. They don't know that it's pieces, pieces of you. Pieces of you.
I think the coolest part will be to see the growth, because they'll have it. We're all in this as we push forward, and I think that that creates that community that we're all looking for.
Best case scenario is any given weekend, Elkin is on the radar of music lovers all over. They're making trips just to come hear music in Elkin.
Well, the town got its lumps up, well, the boundary got its palm. Well, 46 trees got big and a walker, he's a ocean song of a gun.
It's a good feeling. It's a, you know, new page, new chapter. Now it's just all live music and selling beer.
I'm just really proud of them. I think they took on a huge undertaking, and it's taken twice as long in the construction process as they ever anticipated, and now it's finally happening, so it's exciting.
We'd like to think that we could leave something that would make Elkin a little richer, because we've been embraced by Elkin.
I don't know about 100 years, but I hope it'll be here for a long time. And I hope it will be because... Sorry. Because everybody is invested in the theater. You know, the town, the musicians, the people who work there, that will go on and on. And I hope that's the legacy.
I mean this in the most positive way. It doesn't feel like we're in Elkin right now. One day it will feel like we're in Elkin. I think other people will think that's pretty damn cool.
Take a freight train all the way down, all the way down. Back from where you came from, or where you got some, or who you are now. And what you get is, what you got is, or what you've had before. But hold on, darling, gloves are on, why don't you a thing for more? Back blues, them back blues. Things you choose, but you still lose. Now you've done it wrong. You can't remember how to sing that song. Now you got them back blues, them back blues.